Hello, myself Sanjay Kwan. I am working as a head of the Department of Physics, Mahatma Phule AC College, Panvel, District Raigad. Here in the unit number 1 of the SYBC syllabus of paper number 3, that is Applied Physics, unit number 1 is Acoustics, Laser and Fiber Optics. Actually, this syllabus is changed. In FYBC, the laser and fiber optics are shifted from this SYBAC to FYBAC now in semester second. Okay. Now we want to discuss in present lecture regarding unit number 1 and the syllabus of that unit number 1. Okay. Paper number 3, Applied Physics of SYBAC, and unit number 1 is the Acoustics, Laser and Fiber Optics. See, this front or the this photographs show that the actual application of the physics, like by the acoustics, by the laser and fiber optics. See here the arrangement of the auditorium room or the seminar room, you can say that the arrangement shows that to distribute the sound pleasant or audible to the audience, it should be pleasant. Sound should be pleasant or equally intense, or it will be here audience equal sound at every corner, so that we can arrange the auditorium hall or the seminar hall, you can say that the recording rooms, like that the arrangement should be like this one, not like this. See, this is the equal height when we are seated at the classroom. If the hall is very big, then it is observed that the sound should be direct path, can reflect from the floor as well as from the ceiling. The first student can listen carefully or it can be get the audible sound, but as compared to that at the last student, it is quite possible to listen. Okay, means if we are arranged this type of arrangement of the class auditorium room, then we are unable to reach up to the last person. Sometimes sound should be not pleasant due to the reflection of the sound and the path of the sound. It shows that it should be like this in front, first figure and second photograph. It will be observed that when the arrangement is like this, then the sound should be pleasant and equally distributed in the hall, and everyone can listen carefully. And therefore, the acoustic of building or acoustic of the auditorium is very important, and the point of view of that we will discuss this topic. Additional to that, there is another chapter is the laser. Already we know that the laser is the one of the discovery, or you can say that the laser is based on the principle of the Einstein, that is the stimulated emission radiation. Already a laser has the long form as a light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Okay, and the last one is optical fiber optics, or sometimes optical fiber, like that same word is there. See, these are the applications: cleaning, welding, cutting. Addition to that, there is the in medical field, that is the dentistry, medical, 3D printing, electronics. There are a lot of applications are there for the laser. Laser has a wide application in current industrialization. Second thing, addition to that, there is a fiber optics, which is based on the principle of total internal reflection phenomena. And on the basis of that, it is observed that optical fiber has the wide application in the lab, in the fabrication of chips, in the fabrication of the medical diagnosis, or chemical sensing, temperature sensing, environment monitoring, pressure sensing, biomolecular sensing, in the sensor. Or you can say that the optical fiber has the wide application not only in the communication system, addition to that in the medical field, in the research field, in the laboratory purpose, widely used the optical fiber. Okay, we will discuss one by one in this unit number 1, acoustics of a building, second laser and fiber optics. Okay, next is the syllabus. See, unit number 1 has the 15 lecture syllabus, and in which we have the acoustic of building, one first chapter, second is the laser, third is the fiber optics. So here you can see that RK, SP, like that. These are the references, like modern physics, SP means modern physics concept of application by the, written by the Sanjeev Puri and publication in Narosa publication. And second one is the RK, the properties of matter and acoustic, that is R. Murugesan and Shiv Prasad, the Yaschan publication. Both our books are very useful and very good. And you can see that in the properties of matter and acoustic, the Murugesan writing is very good. Means the publication, books publication from the Yaschan are very good one. Easy to understand. They have given the very good derivations, everything. Okay. So generally we can refer the books of the Yaschan publication, which will be helpful. There are the various publications. Narosa publication is also very good one. It has also good liquid language available in the Narosa publication also. Now we go through this syllabus, that is acoustic of building. In this topic we discuss the first of all the study of the propagation generation of the sound. Okay, generally propagation, reflection, or you can say the study of the sound. Okay, there is a reverberation, another phenomena like that. There is a Sabine's formula, one of the W.C. Sabine is one of the scientists which study the more about the propagation of the sound, propagation, generation of the sound. And there is one formula which can be given by the Sabine's formula. The derivation is very long one, but in our syllabus only we have the formula. Okay, so we are just discussing on the formula only. After that, absorption coefficient, acoustic of buildings, factors affecting on the acoustic of building, sound distribution in auditorium. These are the only articles of the syllabus included in our S5BSc. Additionally, that in laser, generally in introduction, we are study about the absorption, emission, transition between the atomic states, then principle of laser, that is the stimulated emission of radiation, properties of laser, that is the coherence, minimum divergence, high intensity and power, and monochromaticity. These are the properties of the laser. Additionally, that there is spatial coherence length, directionality, intensity. And we have in the syllabus helium neon laser, application of laser, and as a holography. Generally, in the new syllabus included in the FIBSC in the semester second, that is laser, the addition of the syllabus is that in including the with helium neon laser, there is a ruby laser is included in the syllabus. Okay. Next, in fiber optics, the light propagation through the fiber, fiber geometry, internal reflection, numerical aperture is a very important thing. It gives the property of, or the property of the laser, or you can say the ability of the fiber to gather the light, okay, or signal. Step index and gradient index fiber is the types of the optical fiber on the basis of index, that is the refractive index of the core. And second thing, there is another type is there, that is the single mode and multi mode gradient index fiber. And I addition that application of the optical fiber is the part of the syllabus. You should refer the reference book. Reference books are the very important when we are going to the deep knowledge of the subject. Otherwise, textbook also available, like said publication. Sometimes textbook of universities are also available in some universities. Okay, according to need, they have provided that. Chapter 1, acoustic of building. In this chapter, we will discuss on the reverberation. What is the reverberation? Second thing, explanation of Sabine's formula, importance of Sabine's formula, absorption coefficient, acoustics of building, factors affecting acoustic of buildings, sound distribution in auditorium. Introduction. Generally, in the first chapter, we want to study about the first of all definition of the acoustic of building. And it is generally study about the control of sound in buildings, cinema halls, auditorium, and the main part is the sound. Okay, the purpose to create the condition that everyone should be hear the sound comfortably. The definition of the acoustic of building is that a branch of physics that deals with the process of generation, reception and propagation of sound is called acoustics. A branch of physics that deals with the process of generation, reception and propagation of sound. First, generate the sound. Second, Reception means receive the sound, and third, the propagation of sound. These three parts are most important in the acoustics of building or acoustics. The branch of physics deals with the study of the planning, designing, and construction of the hall, auditorium, room to provide the best audible sound to every audience is called as the acoustic of building. See, in the acoustics, we study about the only sound, that is generation, reception, and propagation of sound. While in the acoustic of building, we planning or design or the construct the hall or auditorium hall, seminar hall. You can say they are the in case that the theaters, okay, or cinema halls like that. We want to plan or we want to construct this hall in such a way that to provide the best audible sound to the every audience is called as the acoustic of building. Okay, means we are planning the construction, designing the hall in such a way that every audience should listen the sound comfortably, or it should be good, pleasant. What are the essential features about the good acoustics? Means how we can say that there is a good acoustic or acoustic of building is there. So Professor W.C. Sabine scientifically tackled the problem in speech and music in a hall, and he gave the some essential features about the good acoustics. What are that? First, sound heard in an auditorium or the hall must be sufficiently loud to every part of the hall. Means generally, sometimes when we are teaching or when we are talking, we are sufficiently audible to the first 2 to 3 rows in the hall, and at last our sound is quite very low, so they are not able to listen there. Therefore, in auditorium hall, what happens? Generally, sound is not pleasant, or we can say that sufficiently not reach up to the every part of the hall. This is the very important. Sound should be reach up to the every part of the hall sufficiently, or you can say the equally or equal intense. Second thing, there should not be echo. Echo should be absent. Echo means you know that the repetition of the sound is there sometimes when the sees the sound by the speaker. Generally, echoes are very few times it is observed. Otherwise, if there the receivers are there or the wall is made up of the windows, or sometimes we can say that some reflection should be minimized, in that case it is reduced. Therefore, there should not be echo, is very important. Otherwise, when the sound is reflected, we can listen repeatability, and it creates the echo. Generally, quantity of the speech of music must remain the same always. Means when we are going to speak, then our speech should be, our music should be remain same. Generally, what happens, sometimes sound goes to be declined, sometimes we can get the more intense, sometimes decline. Just like when the air is flowing in the surrounding, the sound should be increased, sound should be decreased. This should be not there. Second thing, there should not be overlapping of successive syllabus for the sake of clarity. Generally, what happened due to the echo type, the original sound and earlier sound mixed together, means syllabus are successfully overlapping, and therefore we are confused to listen, or there is no clarity in the sound. So the overlapping of the successive syllabus should be avoided. Second thing, reverberation should be quite proper. Reverberation means what? Multiple reflection of the sound should be occurred in such a way that we can get the sound, and the reverberation should be quite proper. It means when we talk, the reflections of the sound should be up to 1 to 2 seconds. It should be minimized, quite proper, or it should be minimized. There should be no concentration of sound in any part of the hall. Generally, what happens, our arrangement of the sound in such a way that sometimes we are putting the sound box in such a direction, the maximum sound should be concentrated at that direction, and another side it is quite be low. So it should not be that. The sound should be no concentration of sound in any part of the hall. it should be equally distributed in the hall. Boundaries should be soundproof, include extraneous noise. What happens generally, boundaries should be soundproof, means generally what happens, the at the surface of the wall there in many times reflecting surface is there, more smoothness is there. So to avoid that one, soundproof should be there, means it is arranged in such a way that they have be overlap, or we can say that if their walls are there, it should be coated with, or coated, or you can say that leather or something is they're used to absorb the sound which is incident on the walls, or minimize the reflection. Like in auditorium, sometimes you can see that in cinema halls, generally there is some cushions are there, or sometimes clothes are there, so that they can be absorb the loud sound from the walls, which reduce the sound from the reflection from the walls. And there should be no extraneous noise. Extraneous noise means the noise which is created by the outside, okay, that should be reduced. Second thing, there should no echelon effect. Generally, echelon effect is occurred due to the some decorated material which are put in the hall, or sometimes in theater, it can be create this noise due to the air. Sometimes some echelon effect is occurred due to the some variation. There should no resonance within the building. Means when we are talking, the sound should be reflected much more intense, that is resonance occurs. Resonance means enhancement of the amplitude of the sound, and it should be reduced. Okay, there should be no resonance in the. Some definitions, part of the definitions are used in the last article, that is the reverberation. Some definitions are there. Reverberation means what? The persistence of or prolongation of sound in the hall. Even though sound source is stopped, means what, when I am going to talk and I am stopped, still my sound is reflected in the hall, and it should be prolonged sometime due to the multiple reflection. But this prolongation of the sound from the walls, ceiling, floor of the room or the hall is called as the reverberation. When I am going to talk and stop, still my sound is reflected multiple times due to the walls, ceilings, floors, rooms, halls, and therefore it is called as the reverberation. Okay, the time taken for the sound to fall below the minimum audibility measured from the instant when the source stops emitting. Time of reverberation means what? When I am going to stop my words, at the time due to the reflection, the intensity declined, but it is below the audibility, and to reach up to the below audibility, the time is taken. That time is called as the time of reverberation. What is reverberation? Persistence or prolongation of sound in the hall due to what? Reflection. Okay, the prolonged reflection of the sound, okay, is called as the reverberation. And the time required to decline that sound up to minimum audibility or below the minimum audibility, that time is called as the time of reverberation. Time of reverberation is very important. It is sometimes it required the sound decay below the 60 dB from the initial level. Then this time, the generally what reverberation time is, the time required to decay to 60 dB. dB means decibel, from its initial level. Then that time is called as the reverberation time. Means below 60 dB we are unable to listen. Sabine found that the time of reverberation depends on the size of the hall, loudness, sound, kind of music, sound or music or sound. Okay, generally it is very simple. Sabine's formula gives that it depends on the size of the hall, area of the hall, sometimes intensity of the sound, music. Okay, because generally according to sound intensity and other thing, it is absorbed by the materials which are available in the hall. Acoustically good auditorium or the hall where the time of reverberation is negligibly small, means minimized. In case of the speech, series notes are produced in the hall, it's okay, but each one had its own intensity. The rate of decreasing intensity of impulse should be such as to allow others confusion. Generally what happened when we are going to deliver talk in the hall, generally we are talking different modes. Sometimes we are talking very quickly, sometimes we are talking very politely, sometimes we are loudly. So the intensity is different, and according to that the sound should be reach to the everyone with minimum reverberation. Okay, the time of reverberation should be negligibly small, very small. Okay, it is found that generally when we are talking with the frequency of 512 hertz, means 512 hertz, the time of reverberation should be in the range of 1 to 1.5 second, means reverberation time should be very small, that is 1 to 1.5 seconds. Okay, like that one. And it depends on, to minimize the reverberation time, we can use the anti-reverberation materials like porous tiles, asbestos, which can reduce the reverberation time. Okay, we are stop here. Thank you.